California native Terrell Newby into the game for Nebraska here. First and 10 Huskers. Ball at the 49-yard line of UCLA. 7-7 game. Two wideouts to the near side, one to the far side. Armstrong under center. Newby the one back. Westerkamp in motion. Turn. They hand it off to Westerkamp around the right end. He gets upended at the 45. Again, a four. Nice tackle out there by Jaleel Wadu, the sophomore safety. It'll be second down and six. A lot of whistles blowing
another
down
flag
there.
In the backfield. I think it's going to be offsides on UCLA.
Yep.
So Nebraska will take the penalty. It'll be first down and five.
Offside. Defense number 58. It's a five-yard penalty. First down.
Deion Hollins. That's the fourth penalty of the game on UCLA. Nebraska has been whistled for one so far. So first and five from the 44.
And now another big package comes into the game. Lane Hovey at wide receiver. You have a fullback, tight end, and a big running back.
Wide receivers left and right. Under center's Armstrong. Offset eye, cross the deep back. From the Bruin, 44, early second quarter. Ozigbo's in the backfield. Rather, Tommy turns the lay hand off to Ozigbo. He fights his way down to the 40-yard line. 39-yard line, and it's near a first down. Tackled by Matt Dickerson. And they'll eyeball this to see if it's a first down, and it is. So Nebraska moves the chains again. Ball at the 39 of UCLA, and a 7-7 game.
Just sucking them in. Sucking them in. And then we're going to pull it and hit them down the field with a one-on-one. They're going to have to start committing more to the box.
Moore split to the near side. Stanley Morgan to the far side. Armstrong on the shotgun. Ozigbo to his right. A wing to the near side for Nebraska. From the Bruin, 39. Moore in motion. Tommy gets the snap. Zone read. Keeps it himself around the right side. Runs over defender. Gets knocked down at the 36. A gain of three. But Tommy and 6'4", 275-pound Matt Dickerson collide. It'll be second down and seven. Tommy was not afraid of that contact.
Not so sure Tommy didn't win that battle right there. I mean, he's a load, and I'm telling you, he likes to carry it. He likes to run it. Use it.
Ball at the Bruin, 36. Two wideouts to the near side and one to the far side. Terrell Newby in the backfield with Armstrong is in the shotgun. From the Bruin, 36. A minute and a half into the second quarter. Moore in motion. Tommy turns, rolls the pocket to the near side, sets, throws, pass, Westerkamp catches at the 20-yard line. What a grab by Westerkamp. It's a pick of a 16 on the play, and the Huskers once again in the Micro Essentials red zone.
Great throw, and that's two guys being on the same page right there. Tommy threw that ball before Westy came out of his break. He was able to catch it right as he got his head around.
Westerkamp now second in school history in receptions in a season. That was his 63rd catch of the year, ball at the 20. 7-7 game, 13 minutes to go and a half. Armstrong in the shotgun, Ozigbo to his right. Two tight ends in the formation. Snap back. Tommy's going to roll right with the pocket, looking to throw. Throws it downfield, incomplete. Trying to hit Alonzo Moore on the coverage for UCLA. And that far boundary was Randall Gofor, second down and 10.
And a lot of contact as he was getting rid of the football. Got driven into the ground pretty hard. That was a big hit.
Aaron Wallace lowered the boom on Tommy. Second and 10 from the 20. One of the first kind of negative or nothing plays for Nebraska today offensively. They've been picking up a lot of positive yards on first down here today. Armstrong goes shotgun. Newby to his left. Two wideouts right, one on the near side. Snap, a high snap to Tommy. He's going to tuck it and run. Breaks a tackle, the line of scrimmage. Fights his way, the ball comes out. He gets stripped, and UCLA has it at the 14-yard line as Jaleel Wadu pulls it in. Armstrong broke one tackle, the line of scrimmage, and then got chopped over the arms, and the ball came free.
Dang it. A great drive that ends with a hit. Tommy didn't see. Oh, face mask. They missed a face mask.
Oh, yeah.
They missed a big face mask before the ball came out. And that's where you're hearing the boos from Nebraska fans, and deservedly so to these officials. Because that one should have been a penalty and a half the distance to the goal and a first and goal, essentially. Yeah. And instead, it's a turnover.
Rosen under center, Perkins at deep back. They hand it off to Perkins, trying to go around the left side, cuts back up inside, and gets about 4 yards. It'll be second down and six. McMullen and Gary make the Husker tackle. Wow,
boy,
that's
a
big miss.
A big, big miss. He was going right up the middle, and nobody saw it. That's a big face mask, and it pulled Tommy's head down, and really he couldn't see the defender coming because his head got jerked to the side.
Second and six, Rosen again under center. In motion is Walker. Turn the handle off to Perkins. Not much. It'll be third down. No gain. It'll be third and six coming up. Good tackle by Kevin Maurice, who just keeps getting better and better each week. The junior from Florida. And now UCLA faced with third and six. The Bruins only 1 of 3 on third downs. And they go no huddle here with Rosen in the shotgun.
Nebraska better get lined up defensively.
Three wide outs to the near side. Perkins in the backfield with Rosen. Rosen now looks to the sideline. Ball at the Bruin 17-yard line. They move Andrews in motion to the slot. Rosen gets the shotgun snap, holding, set, throws, pass, caught, first down, big play. It's Payton across the 30, across the 35, up to the 39-yard line. So there's Jordan Payton, who had 75 catches on the season, with a big grab there for 21 yards and a Bruin first down up to the 40.
He's a big boy. I was down on the field earlier and watched him warm up a little bit. He's deceptive. He's long arms, a big kid. He's going to be a tough guard out there on the edge.
6-1, 2-12 is Payton. Zone read, play action out of it for Rosen. Looking to take a shot downfield. Fires one deep downfield. A pass is caught, and it's going to be a touchdown for UCLA as Kenneth Walker beat Josh Galoo, and the Bruins immediately turn the Husker turnover into 7 points or 6 points.
Momentum plays in a football game. We talk about turnovers before every single game, and Nebraska turns it over in the red zone, albeit on a missed call. And I mean, I know they can't get them all right, but that was obviously a huge play. And just four plays later, it's a touchdown the other direction.
This is a pretty impressive throw by Rosen. And Walker beat the deep coverage, and UCLA had not taken a shot deep down the field. It was not Kalu. I should change that. It was Chris Jones on the coverage. Here's Fairbairn to try to attack on one more. Snap down, the kick is up, and the kick is good. So UCLA, there's a flag out. Might be offsides on Nebraska on the point after try. I think one of the rush edgers for Nebraska might have jumped a little early.
Has the lead right now somehow. It's 10-7, it's 14-7, whatever. Nebraska is pounding the football down the field against UCLA, and instead, 4 plays later, it's 14-7 UCLA.
11:04 to go in the half. Fairbairn, who's terrific with touchbacks, has it teed up. Stanley Morgan deep for Nebraska. Well, this is an area, kickoff returns, and Nebraska just really needs to try to improve on before next season. That and punt returns, and I know DeMornay's not been a part of this team most of the year, but those two areas have got to get better. Fairbairn's kick, Morgan drifting back. It'll be a touchback.
Yeah, and, you know, Drew Brown really came around early in the season. A few struggles on field goals.
Yeah.
And then really got hot and finished the last half of the season really well. But up until that point, special teams were a big question mark for this football team. Those are the types of things you got to button up in the offseason.
If you're going to be a team that vies for a conference championship, and I think Nebraska loves Sam Foltz, Drew Brown, they like that, but the phase of the returns have to be better for Nebraska. All right, the offense back out there, first and 10 at the 25. Armstrong under center, cross the deep back. Wide receivers left and right. 14-7 Bruins. Tommy turns, hands off to Monty Cross. He gets knocked forward for about 4. So Monty fighting hard. It'll be second down and 6. Jaleel Wadu makes the tackle for UCLA. For an unbeatable game day tradition, reach for the one-of-a-kind taste of Dorothy Lynch. Homestyle dressing, Dorothy Lynch. What you got cooking?
Now let's see how Nebraska responds. Obviously, controversy around that face mask. Give up a big drive. Now let's see if the offense can stay patient, being behind again here in the second quarter, continue to do what has worked.
Armstrong in the shotgun, newbie to his right. Tommy gets the snap, looking to throw. Sets, throws deep downfield, looking for Brandon Riley. Riley makes it. Can he hang on? No, he bobbled it. Couldn't quite hang on to it at the 30 of UCLA. He had beaten the coverage of Marcus Rios. It was a well-thrown ball. Brandon will tell you he should have made the catch, could not hang on. Now it's third down.
Yep, should have been a big gain right there. That, you can't really throw it much better. I mean, that's not even one you have to lay out for. That was nearly a perfectly thrown football. Brandon knows he should have had that one. That's almost one, Greg, he could have caught in stride and kept going. Instead, it ends up in nothing, and now Nebraska faced with a third and medium.
Third and 6, Huskers 3 of 3 on third downs. Armstrong under center, Newbie the deep back. Wide receivers left and right, two tight ends in the set. From the Nebraska 29, play action, back to throw. Tommy setting up the screen, gets it out to Newbie, makes a catch, and he's going to get hit, stopped after a gain of a yard. The throw was a little high. There was intense heat on Tommy shooting through. He had to lob the pass over the rushers to get it to Newbie, who bobbled it for a moment, made the catch, got a yard, but needed more than that. It's a three and out. Nebraska will need to punt it back as Jayon Brown, the leading tackler, made the play for UCLA.
It was actually a nice play by Tommy just to get it to Newbie, but Newbie really nowhere to go. Good defensive effort there from UCLA.
And Sam Foltz, the all Big Ten punter, will come on. Sam averaging 44 yards a punt. Devin Fuller deep for UCLA. Jordan Ober, good snap back. Foltz, a high wobbly kick near the sideline. It's going to go out of bounds. So they don't even let Fuller attempt to retrieve the ball. Let's see where the official walks up the field. It's outside of the 30. 31-yard line is where they'll spot it. 39-yard punt, no return.
It's not complaining,
so it must be okay.
Yeah, it's
right.
Fine.
Yeah.
Little gear underneath here. Layers, Greg.
That's the key. Trips to the far side. One wide out to the near side. Rosen in the shotgun. Gets the snap. Looking. Sets. Throws out a screen pass. It's caught. 35-yard line by Jamaro. He's to the 50, to the 40. And caught from behind and finally wrestled to the ground by Aaron Williams at the Nebraska 32-yard line. They throw it out to Soso Jamambo, who goes for 36 yards. A true freshman running back. Now UCLA in business to the Nebraska 32.
He's hurt. He went down and barely got himself to the sidelines.
Jamabo is their future at that back position. Rosen throws it out to flat. Huskers read it and drill him.
Great play by Williams.
Loss of about five on the play. The pass was caught by Darren Andrews, but behind the line of scrimmage, they're trying to set up a wide receiver screen. Aaron Williams shot the gap and brings him down to the 37, a loss of five.
This is a big drive, I think, right here in this game. Nebraska down 7 points. They give up the big play on first down of this drive. That was a huge play there by Williams.
Rosen, zone read, gives it off. This is Perkins running around the outside. No, it's Starks. And Starks gets inside the 30, down to the 26-yard line. That's a gain of 11 on that little zone read around the right side. Chris Jones makes a tackle. Now it sets up third and manageable, third and four for the Bruins.
Too much on that play. Yep. He put his right foot in the ground, made a nice cut, got up underneath Jones. Pursuit wasn't there. Too big a gain there on a zone read.
Zone in the shotgun is Rosen. Starks in there. Nate Starks, a sophomore tailback. So Perkins not out there this drive.
Big third down here, Greg. Could be four down territory, but they're definitely in range for a field goal.
Two wideouts each way. Rosen gets the shotgun snap, looks, pumps, holds, throws it out in the flat. Starks makes a catch, has a first down, 20, 15, 10, breaks a tackle, 5, touchdown, UCLA. As Nate Starks catches the swing pass, goes 26 yards, and now the Bruins have opened up a 20-7 lead.
That was a nice throw from Rosen out there, Greg. Looked like Nebraska jumped the route out on the outside, but in fact, they were looking for the quick one out to the left side. He just let him clear the defenders, threw it up over the top of Weber towards the sidelines. He made one nice cut, another missed tackle by Nebraska's defense. It's been an issue here in this game so far, and it's going to be 21-7 right now.
Kaimi Fairbairn's point after try is no good. Oh. And the Lou Groza Award winner misses one, but the Huskers were offside. So hang on. A flag on the far side. Nebraska's offside. So Fairbairn.
Defense.
Snap down. This one is good. So UCLA chopped that one up quickly. A four-play, 68-yard drive at a minute 37, and Rosen's second touchdown pass of the day. 7:55 left in the half. 21-7, Bruins with the lead. Their kickoff coming up next.
Pressure to get to Rosen and go one-on-one, or they're going to try to bring forward play coverage. He kicks it out of the end zone. Nebraska will get it. First and 10 out of the 25, but
boy, he's got a leg, doesn't he?
He can really kick it, and jeez, Rosen can really throw it. And if Nebraska can't get home and get pressure on him, it's going to put a... I just don't know that we can cover them out there. One-on-one for sure.
Paul Thurston is in at center for Nebraska. Don't know if Ryan Reeves is
please
hurt.
Please be a bye. But number 81 for Nebraska has switched numbers and is now number 55 working the center position.
So Ryan Reeves out, Paul Thurston in. This might be planned because Nebraska has to replace Reeves next year at center. They might want to get Thurston some work in the bowl game. We'll have Lane check it out from the sideline. Tommy Armstrong under center. Divine Ozigbo behind him. First and 10 from the... And they hand it off to Ozigbo. Ozigbo gets up to the 30, breaks a tackle, and then gets knocked down to the 31-yard line. Again, a six. Good tough run by Ozigbo. Tackle by Wadu and go forth. And so it's a six. Now let's call it 7-yard gain. It'll be second down and 3 for the Huskers at their own 32. 21-7. UCLA with the lead midway through the second quarter here in California. So Paul Thurston at center for Nebraska. Armstrong goes shotgun. Newby to his right. Two wideouts each way. Tight to the formation. Snap back to Tommy. Looking, holding, looking for Westerkamp. Throws it now. Philly's wide open to the 50. Makes a catch. 45. Out of bounds to the 40. And then gets hit late. That should be 15 more. There
it
comes. And that'll put the football at the 25-yard line.
Two 15-yard penalties now on UCLA. They're playing aggressively. And we saw one in, on Nebraska's.
After the play was over, personal foul, number two, defense. That's a 15-yard penalty, first down.
Fifth penalty of the half on UCLA. And the Huskers took advantage the first time they got a personal foul, Matt, went in to score a touchdown. They'll need to do it again here.
Boy, that was, I mean, I don't know. He didn't run through it. It was just really a dumb play by their defender.
And Jordan did a good job, better move, kind of leaned into it.
Yeah, he did.
He goes, you're going to be this close to me. I'm going to. And now flags come out as Nebraska have too many men on the field. Armstrong was running toward the sideline.
There's no foul for breaking the huddle. Number four of the offense called timeout prior to the flag. Timeout, Nebraska.
Smart move.
So, yeah, I think Nebraska had the wrong personnel set on the field, and so Armstrong saw it, quickly called a timeout to avoid Nebraska getting a penalty. So, good play center by Tommy. From the 25 to Bruins. Paul Thurston again in at center. Turner in motion. Huskers turn. Hand it off to Jamal around the end. Cuts back up. Has some running room. 20. Nice move. Inside the 15. Spinning to the 10. Still on his feet to the 5. Jamal Turner driving those legs down to the 3-yard line. What a run by the senior.
A highlight for the senior year there for Jamal Turner. What a nice run. A great cutback. Really slipped a couple of tackles right at about the line of scrimmage. Got hit hard at the 15 and got 12 more yards after that.
What a run for 22 for Turner. First and goal, Huskers of the 3. Down 21-7. 6.5 left opening half. Armstrong will go shotgun. Newby to his right. Two wideouts to the near side. One to the far side. Snap back. Tommy zone read, hands off to Newby. He's in. Touchdown, Nebraska.
Yes, sir, off the left side. Really didn't get touched. Just followed a blocker right into the end zone. What a nice answer by Nebraska, getting it back to a one-possession game.
Sixth touchdown of the year for Newby, and the Huskers back to within a score in this game. And Nebraska does. The long pass play from Armstrong to Westerkamp, followed by the 15-yard personal foul. And the Huskers quickly get right back in this game. Drew Brown to try to tack on one more. Snap down, the kick is up, and the kick is good. So 21-14 now. The Huskers go 75 yards. Four plays, the final three covered by Newby. Terrific run by Jamal Turner. Let's get a Rob Seiko sideline update with Lane Grindle.
You get a sense for how big that drive was, and the Nebraska sideline understood it at the conclusion of that touchdown from Terrell Newby. A lot of smiles, a lot of guys jumping around, high-fiving everybody as they came off. But also, you also got a sense for how excited people were for Jamal Turner. Keith Williams was clear out on the field to go out there and congratulate him after the big run. Nebraska knew that was a big drive they needed to stay in this football game. On the injury front, guys, no official word from UCLA on the status of Soso Jamabo, but it does not look good. He's been over on the sideline laying on his back. They've been working those ACL stability tests and those different knee stability tests on Jamabo. A couple of his teammates coming over to smack him on the shoulder pads with encouragement. A couple of coaches came over and gave him a hug as well. That's typically not a good scene in that type of situation.
Yeah, I would say it's Soso. He's back. No reaction? Lane, no reaction?
I'm steering clear.
All right, here's Drew Brown's kick coming to the near side. Davis grabs it at the 7, to the 15, to the 20, to the 25, and the Huskers, Janovich finally grabs him and knocks him down at the 29-yard line. Actually, they'll say you got to the 30. Let's see if you guys are paying attention. UCLA will have it at the 30-yard line. His name is So-So Jamabo. So. Okay.
Right. So-So.
So-So.
That was So-So.
Yeah, just So-So.
All right, Nebraska's defense has to find a way to get a stop with this offense of UCLA. They are explosive. They have a lot of playmakers. We've seen that speed.
Last eight plays, they've racked up 154 yards of offense. Rosen in the gun. Perkins back in there. Trips to the far side. A wild snap. Rosen gets it. Throws it to flat. Pass is caught in the backfield. The Huskers are going to drop him for a five-yard loss. Nice play made.
Rosen.
Tackle by Jack Gangwish.
Rosen probably should have just thrown that one away, Greg. After the bad snap, got away from him, probably should have heaved it out of bounds.
Steven Johnson made the catch for UCLA. It's a loss of 5. It'll be second and 15. Yeah, that was such a goofy play from the start. In motion is Andrews. Zone read, handoff to Perkins around the left edge. Perkins cuts up field 30, goes down to the 31-yard line, tackled by Banderas. Gain of 6. It'll be third down and 9 coming up for UCLA with 5.5 to go in the half. The 21-14 Bruins.
Nebraska giving bit more of a cushion out on the edges now. Looks like more of a cover four look with deep quarters.
Third and 9. Rosen in the gun. Two wideouts each way. Perkins off to his left. 21-14 UCLA. 5:10 to go in the half.
And now the corners come up and press with two deep safeties.
Rosen
look for the quick slant, Greg, if Nebraska brings heat.
Play clock at 4:32. Rosen gets the snap. Back to throw. Sets, throws, pass, caught, short of the first down. Pass by Duarte, hauled into the 39, but he needed to get to the 40. It'll be fourth down, and the Huskers get a three and out for the black shirts.
Great job making the tackle, not allowing any yards after the catch. And that's going to force a punt. And as I said on the last punt, Nebraska was close to blocking it. Let's see if one of the Nebraska guys right over the ball, which looks like...
And the punter bobbles the snap, but gets it off. Not a very good kick, but he angles it away from Westerkamp. It goes out of bounds and around the 30-yard line of Nebraska. They will say that it goes out at the 27 of NU. So it's a 31-yard punt, no return. And so the Huskers will take over the chance to get this game tied before halftime.
Absolutely. Big drive here. And remember, Nebraska won the toss. So the Huskers will get the ball to start the second half. That was a big stop right there for the Husker defense.
Tommy Armstrong leads the Husker offense out. It's an offset eye across the deep back. Armstrong under center. Wide receivers left and right from the Husker 27. Riley in motion back toward the line of scrimmage. Delay handoff to Cross. Amani pushes his way across the 30, fights his way to the 32. It's a gain of 5. It'll be second and 5 as Matt Dickerson makes the Bruin tackle. 4:10 left to go in the half. UCLA 21, Nebraska 14.
Whatever you do here, you don't want to give it back to UCLA. Nebraska can have back-to-back possessions here if they could somehow bleed it out here in the first half and then get it to start the second.
Shotgun look this time with Cross to the right of Armstrong. Wide receivers left and right. From the 32, Tommy gets the snap. Back to throw on a play action. Looking downfield, throws for Seaton Carter. Makes a catch at the 50. Fights his way inside the Bruin 45 to the 44-yard line. Seaton Carter, his second catch of the game. 25-yard pickup. Huskers in business.
You can just see his confidence just really growing. The last few weeks really come into his own. That was a nice catch and a good run after the catch. Nice job by Tommy, too, getting it to him.
Tommy had to put that in a bit of a window that time. There were defenders all around Carter. Huskers have it at the Bruin 44. 3.5 to go in the half. Shotgun look for Armstrong. Backs on each hip. Now Newby splits out. Zone read. They hand it off to Janovich to the 40, 35. Tripped up on the 32, but it's a 12-yard gain for Andy Janovich as Jaleel Wadu makes the UCLA's tackle, but not before the Huskers move the chains.
Janovich hit the ground hard after getting his legs taken out from him by the safety. Big hole up the middle on the right side, though.
TD Ameritrade, an Omaha-based company, a proud sponsor of Husker football. We'd like to thank them and their associates for their support. Under center is Armstrong. Divino Zigbo behind him. Turner in motion back to the line of scrimmage. Hand off to Zigbo off the left side. Divine gets down to the 30 and corralled there by a couple of Bruins. It'll be second down and eight. 2:40 to go in the half. As Aaron Wallace, the first backer on the scene for UCLA. Good football game here tonight. 21-14 Bruins by 7. Huskers driving.
A lot of good offense. Some missed tackles, so maybe you could say some bad defense too, but these offenses have been pretty good. We've seen almost 500 yards of offense already in the first half.
Tight formation. Armstrong in the shotgun on second and eight. Snap back into illegal motion. Huskers move just a tick early that time. And remember, you have a different center in there in Paul Thurston.
Paul start.
I think it was Alex
offense,
Lewis.
Offense, number 71. It's a five-yard penalty, second down.
Third penalty of the first half on Nebraska. Now you're behind the chains a bit, second and 13. Huskers have two timeouts left. So does UCLA. 2:10 to go in the half. So got to start keeping your eye on the clock a little bit here. Nebraska still huddling up. Ball to 35 of the Bruins. Backs on each hip of Armstrong is in the shotgun. Wide receivers left and right. Newby now splits that again. Out of the same formation. Tommy keeps it after the fake to Janovich to the 30, 25, 20. Armstrong 15 down inside the 10. What a run by Armstrong. It's first and goal. Big red at the 9.
He is so explosive. When he puts the foot in the ground, it goes north and south. He showed it right there. A great run. And first and goal. Slipped a couple of tackles. Showed some speed.
26-yard run by Armstrong. Huskers have it at the 9-yard line. First and goal with a minute 35 to go in a half. The Huskers once again in the Micro Essentials red zone.
Both teams have two timeouts left.
High formation. Cross the deep back from the 9. Carter in motion to the near side. Only one wide out in the pattern. Turn, handoff to Cross. Huskers go power around the left edge. Cross to the 5. Lowers his shoulder. Knocked out of bounds and around the 2. So Amani Cross with a strong run off the left edge for 7. He gets up screaming toward the Husker bench. That's one fired up senior playing here tonight.
Man, it didn't look to me like he was going to get that much out of it. But he did a great job getting the edge, putting a head down and getting to the 2.
Second and goal. A minute 14 to go before halftime. A 21-14 Bruin lead, but the Huskers knocking on the door. Huskers will go with a Maryland I formation. Cross the deep one. Armstrong under center. Now they split out. Carter to a wing. Armstrong hands it off to Amani. Cross to the 1. He's short of the goal line. It'll be third and goal. Tackle made by the All-American Kenny Clark for UCLA. And a timeout taken
by UCLA.
And there's a Husker slow to get up. That's Amani Cross. Let's go get a Rob Seco sideline update with Lane Grindle.
Yeah, Amani still having a hard time kind of catching his breath. He's still standing just as he got up. And maybe just a tad bit of a limp as he's walking back towards the Husker huddle. Mark Myers come out to the
options in this game.
No question. And could actually have the lead.
Third and goal. The triple I. Armstrong under center. Cross the deep back. Paul Thurston again at center, the junior. Tommy looks over the defense. Splits out Carter. Long count. Turns. Hands it off Janovich. He's in. Touchdown, Nebraska.
He was easily in. Raise your hands in the air. Goodness.
And the Huskers have pulled him into the point. 21-20.
Janovich had already gotten up and ran back to out of the end zone by the time the officials put their hands in the air. Everybody knew it was a touchdown except for the guys that matter. The only good news for Nebraska on that is it ran 11 seconds off the clock when it really took 1.
Here's Drew Brown to try to tie it with 52 seconds left in the half. Nebraska with an impressive march. Snap down. The kick is up. And the kick is good. It's a 21-all game with 52 seconds left in the half. As Nebraska gets the touchdown run from Andy Janovich, his third rushing touchdown of the season. As the Huskers just went 73 yards in 8 plays, 4:01 off the clock. We have a tie game here right before halftime.
Goodness, what a great comeback for Nebraska. 21-7. A lot of people watching this game say, looking at it and going, oh, UCLA's too fast. Oh, they're too explosive. They have better players than Nebraska. And here we are, 21 apiece. I love the fight in this team right now to come back and tie this thing. They needed a big stop, remember, and they got it. They go down and get the big drive. They got another 15-yard penalty on UCLA two drives ago. Then they get another stop, get it back, go right down the field and tie the football game.
Of that eight-play drive, seven of those were runs. The one pass to Seaton Carter on that. But on the scoring drives for Nebraska, they've had 24 plays. 21 of the 24 plays have been runs. So Nebraska has become a running football team here tonight, and they are tied. Drew Brown hammers a high end-over-end kick. Davis comes up, makes a catch at the 5. Davis to the 10, 15, 20. Scoop to the outside, and he's going to be swarmed under at the 18-yard line. Good kick coverage. Chris Weber knocked him down. So UCLA with one timeout left, 44 seconds. I don't think they'll just sit on it here. I think with Rosen, they'll try to push it down the field.
No question about it. They're going to try to get at least in a field goal range. They have a kicker who's made a 60-yarder. So, they're looking at it and saying, okay, what do we need here? 35 yards, maybe 40 yards. The clock stops after a first down.
They'll have a ways to go starting from the 18-yard line. Rosen on the shotgun.
Maybe they'll turn it over here. That'd be nice.
Yeah, two wideouts each way. Rosen gets the snap. Play action's out of it. Gets hit as he throws downfield. Pass is incomplete. Boy, he got drilled.
He did.
And it was it McMullen or was it Kevin Williams? I think it might have been Kevin Williams that got him. Rosen slow to get up, second and 10. And there's an injured Husker down at the end of the play, back where the ball was thrown. And it is Michael Rose Ivy who is down in pain at the 35-yard line. McMullen,
the ruling field is an incomplete pass. Therefore, there is no 10-second runoff.
Nebraska hit Rosen right in the head on that play.
McMullen.
Greg McMullen. Didn't get a penalty. Definitely hit Rosen high. And if he felt that one, that's the biggest hit Nebraska's put on him. Might be the only hit Nebraska's put on him.
Well, now the concerns on Michael Rose Ivy, the junior linebacker who has had all kinds of injury situations in his Husker career. This has been a really good football game here tonight. 21 all. 39 seconds left, so the incomplete pass, and here's the good news. Michael Rose Ivy now jogging, now slowly walking toward, he's starting to kind of put some pressure on it and stop, but he's walking toward the sideline.
So he gets healthy and gets ready for next ball.
Second and 10, ball to 18. So Rosen. The Huskers training staff studying Michael Rose Ivy's body language as he comes off. So Rosen in the gun. Perkins is right, two wideouts each way. Gets a snap. Sets up the screen to Perkins. He makes a catch and gets lit up by Nate Gary. And a flag comes out. They're going to get Gary for a high hit here. It's going to be a high hit on Gary. Boy, he timed that beautifully and drilled him at the 17-yard line, but hang on, or maybe a penalty.
Could be a helmet-to-helmet, and could it be another one of those that gets Gary an early exit?
Remember, he got ejected at the Iowa game.
Personal foul. Targeting. 25. Defense.
Boy, I just don't
see... Play is under further review.
I just don't see targeting out of that at all. I see a guy making a big... big tackle.
We're seeing it for the first time.
Oh, it's just a good football play, man.
You know, it's here's the problem with this, okay? You're putting defensive players in a position, and he didn't try to lead with his head. He tried to lead with his shoulder. But because it looks the way it looks, you have officials that are just quick to throw the flag. And here's the problem, Greg. If you're the guy catching the ball out there, was that their running back catching out Perkins out of backfield? You think Perkins wants to get hit in the kneecap? It could break his leg. It could blow his knee. If you're Perkins, when your quarterback lays you out like that, you're either going to get hit high, and it might hurt a little bit, but if he hits you in the knee, it could end your career. And so that's my problem with how far we have taken these hits. I just don't know what the defensive player is supposed to do. This was not a malicious hit at all. Was there any contact with the head? Maybe a little, but this was not a malicious hit.
It's a good football play. They're now reviewing it to see whether Nate Gary will be ejected. He was ejected in the Iowa game.
There is no way there. This is an ejection, Greg. This one barely, he might not have even touched his helmet. He led with his left shoulder. this was not ejectable.
Lane?
Nate Gary even turned his head at the last second to try to get it out of the way so there wasn't any helmet contact, period. Not just on helmet to helmet, but even on the shoulder pads of Perkins. And we're getting to a point now where you're going to have to let guys catch it, make two or three steps, and then you're just going to have to tackle them around the waist, or you're not going to be able to tackle people anymore.
Mike Roddy was not happy at all. He was out in the ear hole of a couple of different referees pleading his case. To the naked eye, it was a good football play, and the replays back that up. What I'm getting nervous about is this is a long time this official's been on the headset down here.
Well, hopefully the guy up here is telling him that was a bad call and he's getting chewed out. Because, I mean, look, Perkins caught the ball and had come down with both feet. So at what point does he become a runner and all of that stuff? It's not like he was in the air and Nate Gary caught him in the air and planted him. I don't know. This one is not a malicious hit to me. It's going to be a 15-yard penalty and a first down, and I think that's it.
They are still discussing this with the official. He still has the headset on. That's the longer this goes, man, I'm just nervous this is going to be the ejection of Nate Gary. Lane?
Well, here's the other point on that. Nate Gary went in high because if he lowers his head, then it looks like he's got his head down, and that looks like targeting. So he kept his head high, and that's where the helmet contact, if any, actually happened, occurred.
All right, we have a decision forthcoming. The headset is off. Here's Ron Cherry.
After review, the ruling on the field of targeting is confirmed. Number 25 is disqualified.
This has gone too far.
UCLA has elected not to use the 10-second runoff.
I mean,
wow.
You were right, Greg, and I can't believe it.
Yep.
I just think this has gone too far.
Mike Roddy is hot.
This has gone too far. I feel terrible for Nate Gary. He comes up from the safety spot and makes a play. I hope this gets a lot of attention nationally because it's a bunch of baloney.
Rosen back, throws a deep fade, pass is nearly intercepted by Josh Kalu. Maybe he did get it. Josh Kalu with a pick for Nebraska. What an interception at the Husker 38-yard line. Great play by Kalu. That is his third pick of the season. What a play by number 10.
My goodness, they look for Perkins on a wheel route down the left sideline right in front of the UCLA bench. And wouldn't you know, we're going to get another play that's under review, but this one's going to stand. What a great play by Kalu.
The previous play is under review.
Wow, I just got the bad feeling going back to the Gary hit, as long as that took, that they were going to deem that he was out. And I don't know how in the world, when he's hitting him with his shoulder, how that is head-to-head. It's just a baffling call.
Well, Lane should find Mike Perret down there. I don't know. Maybe according to the rules, maybe it's right. And then I'm telling you the rules wrong. I'm telling you as a football player, Greg, if you ask Perkins right now, you want Nate Gary to hit you the way he did?
The ruling on the field is confirmed. It's an interception, first down.
Do you want Nate Gary to hit you where he did, or do you want Nate Gary to hit you in the knee? I mean, in the hip. It's going to be worse if he goes low.
Yep.
And it was an awful, it's awful circumstances that it came to this, that Nate Gary's now in the locker room missing this bowl game because of either a bad rule or a bad interpretation of the rule by these officials. Whichever one it is, I don't even know the rules anymore. They've changed them so many times. There's a young man who's not in this game, and it's not right.
Huskers take over the 38-yard line, 23 seconds to go in a half. Under center's Armstrong. Back play action. Huskers going to take a shot here, and Tommy gets sacked. He gets knocked out at the 30-yard line. A sack, the first of the game for UCLA, and that might run the clock out. It was Kenny Clark, the All-American, who made the tackle on Tommy. And the Huskers will let the clock expire. We will go to halftime in a good half of football that ends with some controversy with Nate Gary getting tossed out of this game and will not be a part of this second half for the Huskers. 21-all, Nebraska and UCLA here at the Foster Farms Bowl. Our halftime coming up next.
This is the University of Nebraska President's Halftime Show. The University of Nebraska, focused on the future of our state and of our world. One university, four campuses, one Nebraska.